हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल गो डिजिट। वेल, एज यू नो, दिस इज़ द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेस सीरीज। इन द पार्ट वन वी हैव सीन हाउ टू सेटअप द मास्टर्स एंड द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग सेटअप्स इन ऑर्डर टू जनरेट और प्रोड्यूस द एफजी आइटम इन आवर सिस्टम। सो इन आवर केस वी हैव यूज्ड एफजी आइटम एज स्पेक्स and we are using two raw materials, one is frame and second one is glasses. Okay, so if I look at this slide, so as I mentioned that in the first part we have seen how to create or set up the item master, how to set up the production BOM, how to set up the work center or the machine center. I have missed one thing in setting up the work center. I will inform or explain the same in this series only. And the next step is that we have learned how to set up the routing and link the same with my FG item. Okay, so in this in the second part of the series we will learn how to receive the inventories of raw material, then how to create the production order, then how to post the consumption entry and the output entry for my FG item, and then changing the status of production order to finish. So let's get started. So these are our three items. This is our FG item and these are our two raw materials. Now the first step is to increase the inventory of our raw materials in order to produce this item. As we can see that we have already enough inventory available for frames and glasses, because if I look at this my FG item, here we have already seen that in the production BOM we have mentioned that we need only one quantity of frame and 0.2 kg of glasses to produce the same FG item. So we can clearly see from here that in the inventories part that we have the available inventory for frame and glasses, so we will not receive the raw materials any further. But if you would like to receive, then you can either make the use of item journal or through the purchase order to receive the inventories of these two raw materials. Okay, so now the next step is to create the production order. But before that, I would as I mentioned that I have missed one part while setting up the work center. So I'll explain you here that when you go to the work center and when you create the master for the work center, there is one thing that when we assign our shop calendar code, let's say we have assigned here one shift Monday to Friday, so ideally what we need to do is that we first have to go to our calendar and click on show matrix. Then here we have one batch available as calculate. So in this calculate work center calendar, you have to create a capacity plan in the system for the year or for your future years in order to help the system to plan the production or the purchase through planning worksheet automatically. So I have already done that. What you can do is based on the year on which you are working. For example, currently we are in 2020. So I will mention here as 2020 and you can run the batch as click OK. So what it will do is, first of all, yes, you have to select the work center also here. So, and then click OK. So what it will do, it will create a capacity planner or capacity planning lines and assign it to your work center, so that system will have the particular information that yes, we are available, or this work center or cutting center is available to for these lines or for these months or days. So let me run it, go to the calculate and here mention the 2020 and I will run it for my both work centers as W this one. Okay, it is not taking. Okay, so we have to run it per work center wise, I think. So let me run it for my another work center. Select my this work center as here and click OK. And now it is done. Let's create a production order now. So in my case, I'm creating a release production order. Click on, these are the existing production order which are yet not completed. Okay, so let me click on new to create a new production order. Generate a production order number. Type the description here as produce specs. So in the source item, select the available option from here as item, and in the source number mention your FG item number, which is 70063. Okay, now in the quantity you have to mention that how much quantity you would like to produce. Okay, let me check on which date I'm working. I'm sorry guys, I have to first change my work date. Basically it is 2020. Okay, now let me click on new again. Produce, let me input only specs. Okay, here mention your FG item number. Input the quantity as one because you would like to produce only one quantity. And now, after this, just go to the process and click on refresh production order. In the refresh production order, your system will ask you that you would like to calculate the lines, routings, and the components required to generate or produce the your FG item automatically or not. Okay. So just keep it the same and click on OK. And now you will see that lines are automatically filled, that it is mentioning here that starting date time is that if I start on 27th of January 2020 and around 1 p.m. then it will take me 3 hours to complete the same of or produce the quantity of one for my FG item. Okay, right now you are seeing the unit cost as zero, you know, because it we must have to calculate as per our cost incurred in the raw material section and in the routings operations. So to check that, go check your line functions and select the production journal here. And here you can see the system automatically created the lines. That first two lines are of the consumption. Consumption means that these are our two raw materials, and we system will pose the negative adjustment or the consumption to reduce the inventory of frame by one and glasses by 0.2, because these are the quantities which we mentioned in our production BOM. And then after the consumption, system will use the work center. First it will use the cutting center, and then it will go to our pasting center to produce my FG item. Okay, so here the use of the flushing method, we must have to understand that right now we have seen that we are using the flushing method as manual. But if manual means that we have to manually post our this production journal and post the consumption entry and output entry manually. In case you not like to post these entries manually and you want system should handle all these things automatically, then you can make the use of either forward or the backward in the flushing method. Okay, so what it suggests that if you use the forward, then when you create any firm plan production order and change the status of that order to released, then at the time of releasing of production order only, system will post this journal automatically. And if you use backward, then at the time when you change the status of your release production order to finished, system will automatically post this journal entry. But in our case, we are using manual only. Okay, so now it is showing correct values here. In case you would like to mention any scrap, you can mention here also if you have forgot to add it in the master. Okay, but in our case it is quite okay. So now the next step is to click post, and now my journal lines are posted successfully. Okay, so this means that now finished quantity is 1 and remaining quantity is 0. That means my item has been produced successfully. But guys, still our cost is not updated. That if you see that, you can click on actions and here you can click updated unit cost and all levels, click OK. And now you can see that unit cost is now available as 32. And why this 32 is coming here? Because if you see that in our work center, we have used, let's say, I'll show you that. Let me open it in a separate page. And then as you can see that we have purchased this item for the cost of rupees of dollars 10. Okay, so 10 is added in this my FG item cost. Now if I look at this second raw material, then here our cost is 10 again. So for this also 10 is added in this my FG item. So the total cost is now 20 to produce my FG item. But no, sorry. Actually 10 is, I'll explain you again, that the unit cost of 1 kg is 10. But for this item, we are using only 0.2. So that is why the cost per unit cost for to produce this item is $2 only against this order. So now the 10 part comes from this and 2 part will come from this. So the total cost of this item till now is 12. Okay, now let me show you that from where system actually added $20 in my FG item. So if I see and go into my work center, then here we can check it out that we have mentioned the cost for this work center as 10 and for this work center also as 10. So the total cost for the operations which we have done on our FG item from these two work center is 20. So 20 from work center and 12 from my raw materials. So the total cost which system automatically calculated for my FG item is 32. So ideally we do not have to do anything, but we can mention the cost in our raw materials and our work centers, and system will automatically handle the unit cost for your FG item. Now the next step is, because we have done everything to our production order, we can change the status from release to finish. Okay, here also, if you do not want to use the update cost batch in the production order, when you are changing the status of a production order to finish, here also you can run the batch by putting it to true. But I have already done that, so I will not use this. Now click here, select this finish part and click yes. And now my production order, release production order is finished, and that is how my manufacturing cycle completes by creating raw material masters, FG master, and how we can use it in our production order. So guys, if you like this video, just please click on the like button and please subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.